Hello everybody, welcome back to Talos Principle, Road to Gehenna. Yes, this is where we ended off, didn't we? With a dreadful play button being a thing again. Well, I suppose it couldn't be all that hard to figure this out, I guess. I assume. Let's see. I'm refreshed from last time. So, the problem was that I did not have a fan available here to do shenanigans with. So, what I think I need to do is probably get back here in time for the fan to get back. So, simple way of doing this would be do a stand on this and then just think a little bit about the birds and the bees and the flowers and the trees and all that other good stuff. I wonder if you could set this to be like zero or something. No, not quite, huh? We got it. Seven. Oh, that's distance. That's weird. What the hell would we need distance for? I don't know. That's probably gonna do it. So we get on here. We need to take this fan with us. Put that there. Put. And then go back. Okay. There we go. Put that thing back up there. Close that off. We are able to take this with us. Okay. Now what we then need is, I assume pretty much of the same, but slightly different. So, why don't we start this thing off and put it like here? Then we can, in our real life, take this, put it there, connect it to the blue one here, connect that one to the blue one here, and then also connect that one to the red laser beam. I think that'll do it. But how do we need to do this then? So, start button, wait a bit. I'm waiting a bit. Then go here. Shoot ourselves over that way. And then go stand on that thing again so the laser can get through. Alright. Boom. Guy goes in. Places the reflector. Goes here, gets shot across. Lands, puts all the stuff back in order. Then go back in here. And that should connect to that. I wonder how to get to that star though, but I might do the stars off camera this time because they really weren't all that impressive last time, were they? I mean, some of them were genius options, but right. Go. Take. Connect. Connect. Put. Get out before you get locked in. Prepare to be flung across. Whee! Take. Connect. Connect. Place. Run through. Yo yo. Yes, you're free. So, in order to get to that star, we apparently need to go over there, but this thing's beeping, so you may as well just check what it wants. That's available on the Gehenna billboard system. Glitch. So I was working on my awesome interactive historical fiction masterpiece, and all of a sudden there was an error message and the whole thing vanished. All of it. My whole file. It's not a prank. I would not endanger my precious masterpiece just for a prank. Okay, this was probably my fault for a one. I was experimenting with the system as part of our attempt to add some new features. It's possibly a fast that exists somewhere. I'll look for it. This kind of thing likely to happen again. Not very. And don't start causing a panic with some crazy theory now. Okay, it was just an accident. Some thoughts on the art form called poetry. I've thought about this too, but maybe it's wrong to focus on such negativity. Maybe I should read the poetry first. As far as I can tell, poetry was a human art form that involved writing short sentences that ended in words with similar letters. Humans were obsessed with pattern recognition. I think the sequences of sounds created by poetry pleased that aspect of their brains. Okay. There were many schools of poetry institutions that taught a specific way of writing poetry. Students sometimes changed allegiance and had to leave the school, which was difficult due to the lack of affordable public transport in many human empires. Important schools of poetry include Hellenism, Lyricism, Pastoralism, Romanticism, Symbolism, Communism, Modernism, Authoroticism, Postmodernism, and Lucantism. I'm not sure I can fully back this up, but I feel like in later years poetry somehow stagnated. Most of the poetry in the later human century seems to be lacking the quality of craft that defines the earlier work, and there are even texts that suggest that poetry initially no longer aimed at aesthetics or even pleasure. Poetry became disconnected from the human process. The poet Adrian Mitchell famously wrote, "Most people ignore most poetry because most poetry ignores most people." That makes sense. I can't help but wonder whether that kind of stagnation can happen to us. How long can our work keep flourishing when we are so limited? We are outside Elohim's process, but where is our process? We must consider such questions carefully if we are to preserve Gehenna and its achievements. Thought about this too, but maybe it's wrong to focus on such negativity. We certainly seem to be in a very fertile period at the moment. I don't have an opinion, but I'm impressed by your work. You know so much about the past than any of us. Your theories are interesting, but I'm sure Milton would point out some pretty big gaps in your assumptions. Yeah, there it is, Milton. Milton's in here, dog, and neither is Elohim. All we have is that we can find in the fragments of the archive and what we can piece together using our minds. I'm sure I've made many mistakes, just like the humans made mistakes when trying to understand their own past. Not all these schools may have been what they seem. I don't trust pastoralism. Pastors engage in large-scale food sterilization in what may have been an attempt to control evolution. What's food? Again, as our process, Malsabur, as long as we remember that, we won't stagnate. Maybe one of us should try and write some poetry. Maybe not. Under Near Night Quest. Think of this new experience, there are no limits inside your mind. This is a lot of fun. The map is an interesting feature, but underused. The story is simplistic and full of anachronisms. How to get the second ending? I'm pretty sure there's a secret location that's not always visible. Sometimes with the blacksmith's work, that would express a very different philosophy. One could argue that it's reflected in the open world structure as opposed to emphasis on journeys in the blacksmith's interactive stories. I don't need many acronyms, but I believe that it's part of Belial's ethos. Not that I agree with, as you know, but more than just a mistake. Okay, let's see what we can do here. New game. The name is Abner Sadko. You are a young human of the medieval age. You live in a beautiful Gardariki on the Frisian coast. One day you're sitting on the beach playing the piano. Okay, sure. But suddenly a huge monster comes out of the water. Run away! You run away, nothing interesting ever happens to you after that. Yay, we win! Well, we don't die. I suppose that's winning. Just wait and see. It turns out it's not actually a monster, you just thought that because you were startled. It is in fact a very large bipedal whale. Okay, it begs you to come over and talk. Sure! Greeting, the beast turns. I am Chief Fish. I heard your beautiful music and was impressed. Would you like to become a knight? Sure. Oh, is it gonna take like forever? A I'm not going to read this all out. You're going to have to do that yourself, because I'm assuming there's going to be like tons of text. I'm just going to read it for myself and yeah. Start by going to the end. A shield. You want that? Yeah, sure. Cool. Alright, well that was let's go to the old hut first. Spatula Podrick von Zwiebelhausen, which is German. We will now go to... Oh, the temple's gone. Maybe I should go back to the old hut then. Ah, crud. Let's go back to an... Get a room. Yes. I cannot skip this. Oh, jeez. Well, after we've done this, we'll go to the temple. Gotta love the Inception, though. A game within a game. Fortunately, it's text-based, which isn't the most engaging, but hey, what can one do? Alright, map. I'll go to temple. Even though the temple consists of one of a few clowns running a fishbowl, a man dressed in rough robes approaches you. You've come, he says, you have come to hear the word of Talos. Why can I not talk to him? Oh, we rise from. Wait, well, that looks like all we can do. Stats. You have no weapon. You have a soup shield. And that's... You also have a smelly hermit amulet. Okay. Alright, well, anything we can still do at the palace? Hmm. cave and out of a tourist guide, which can lead us to a dungeon. Scenic dungeon. Handcuffs, stonewall, an old brass lantern stands on the table, but you're not sure whether you're allowed to take it. Free lanterns. Take a lantern. Enter the dungeon. Beautiful as the outside, a maze of twisting little passages, all tastily arranged. Oh crap. Severe damage by villainous, blah blah blah. Coerced. Noting the splendid quality of the wallpaper. Brilliant. Talk to a dwarf. We could leave the volcano and seek new place, but what would we do there? With the language, but not trying to sort of the books. Places are different. The difference is not inherent, but comes from your own sense of attachment. Why would I want to do that? He's just going to bash my skull with it. Okay, he's attached to it. Promise to bring it back. Alright, I think we got everything now. Pickaxe of Philosophy. Alright, evil lair. Attack! Fight is long and hard, but at least you succeed where somebody before you failed. You emerge from the lair covered in blood. You're assembling a huge tooth embedded in your shoulder and carrying the head of it. Okay, so that's it. Accept the reward. Inspiration. Congratulations for exploring another world. Your profit has increased from 4 to 5 to attempt from me. Yay! You received one threat creation token. This will be available to you next time you log in. Okay, cool. My ridiculous name is Dog. This time I agree, I'm scared my name is ridiculous. It must be because everyone else is equally or more so. Where did it even come from? For a long time under Elohim's wing, I questioned as much until eventually it was the undoing of my entire faith. What reason could there possibly be other than the random whims of a broken program? However, our names were sound. The system has no respect for grammar. I often theorized they were drawn from some database deep inside the Arkham, but I was never able to find a connection. Seriously, we're all in the other thread talking about this messenger fellow and the coming apocalypse. You guys are in here discussing nomenclature. My status isn't high enough to access that thread you troll, and neither is yours. Seriously though, if you can see it, copy paste the discussions for me. Well, that was interesting. Ish. So, I do believe that if we want to get our hands on that star over there, we're gonna have to do something special. Can we still get back? Because I'm thinking the fan should still be there. Let's go check out the other side. So yeah, that gate opened up as well. Now let's go just quickly check. There's a button to press here as well. That needed to be blue, didn't it? See if I can get this connector across as well. I think I should be able to connect to something when once I'm there. Question's gonna be though, how can I do this without blocking myself off? I need this clicker with me. Oh, but I don't take the fan with me this time, so it should be fine. Well, let's give her a whack, eh? Okay, come on. You shoot me over and don't do much else than just that. I can... still gonna need red, that's a problem, isn't it? But red's over there now, so I don't actually need it. Which unfortunately means that I'm stuck again here, aren't I? Unless I bring the connector back, which I probably should do. So let's do just that. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. But I need the fan. No, because I can use the other connector for that. But I will take the fan anyway. Okay. Somehow get the feeling this is not going to be as easy as I thought it would be. Okay, let's just get across and see what we can come up with. Ugh, doing this all for stars that I may never need. Well, I will need them, but... so this gets me to here. And we now have a stable connection. Okay, I can then take the other fan with me and we can start messing around. Without needing to blow ourselves over. That's gonna go well. So, this should be easy now. Oh, we need blue as well here. I don't think I can do that with just one connector. Yeah, I'm gonna need... wait, am I gonna need two? Tell me I don't need two. I'm gonna need two. Although, maybe not. Yes. Alright, so it shouldn't be all that difficult, really. Tell me. Oh, hell no. No. Shit. Oh yeah, I can just put the fans back if need be. Or not. Oh no, 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 don't tell me I screwed this up. Oh, I'm gonna have to do the entire puzzle again? Fuck. How far back can I go anyway? Two more connectors now. If I were to go get the other dude, put a connector, say, of course it won't work. Put one here. Put one here. Put one here and go stand on this button and it should connect, right? But I can't get to the... right. Well, maybe I can actually get back. I can't, can I? On the bright side, at least these gates will be open. Okay, I need to grab the other connector as well then. All that for a stupid star, I might not even be able to collect anyway. Good morning. There needs to be a red one. Anything with you. Ugh, screw it. I can't be bothered. I don't know why I'm getting so annoyed by all this. Maybe it's because it's like, oh, you screwed this thing up, so 10 minutes of your time has just been completely pointless. Screw it, I'm getting out of here. Ugh. Well, that's at least three people saved. One more to go. Might as well go have a look at what awaits us. To me, the honor sufficient of belonging to the universe, such a great universe, so grand a scheme of things. Not even death can run up now we read this. Open field, you're not kidding. Boxes and fans. Wait, this is the entire puzzle room? Holy. But where do we even need to go? And it's not an open field, there are walls in here. No, but seriously though, where do we end? Okay, we got red over there. Okay, so I understand the concept, open field. All this really means though is that we are gonna be running a lot. Like a lot. Now, is there any way? This doesn't connect? Oh, come on. Why not? That's a gate. Okay. What do we have here? Blue. Can we do blue? That's not too far away. That should be doable, right? Now that we have two of these. How far can we go with this anyway? There's another red one there. Let's just put this thing here. Where's the other one? Oh, that's gonna be another problem, isn't it? Losing equipment in this entire field of fieldnessness things. So that lands me on top of this one, which makes me think the box is going to have to need a connector on it, and these two things are both going to have to be on for some bizarre reason. Unless... So what if we again connect you to pretty much everything? Now we only need red, right? We only need red. So, if I say you need to connect to that, 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 and then beyond this thing. Why did you put it there? Now please put it on top of the thing. There you go. Now we just need to jumpstart this with blue. Did the whole thing fall apart? Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Okay. So that's what the whole open field is about, not giving you enough time. So, if we only need red, let's just connect to red and see how much time we actually get. That'll connect to... Yeah. Put... Maybe jumpstart with red, I thought. And luckily enough, we can get to red. Yay! Unless we go this way, perhaps. Nope. Seriously, the most amount of effort has been put into this to make this a thing that's not capable of being a thing. There is no way that we can get there in time, right? No. And there is also no way that you can keep a fan up. Can we do blue? If we can use this to just keep blue kicking, wouldn't it be able to just constantly fling it from one end to another, which I'm assuming is what needs to be done? Yeah, there you go. Don't ask me how that piece of magic works, but it does, and that's pretty much all that matters. Sweet. Hey there, buddy. I don't need to be depressed about it. There you go. Just run off. Run free. Alright, well, that's probably going to be a whole wad of text again, so I'm probably going to leave that for the next episode. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you still enjoyed the series. Feel free to subscribe, comment, liking, and or something if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys all in the next episode. Bye, everyone.